evening. I'm Nicholas Hoare. Those of our readers who are fond of Anthony Bourdain will recognize that there are such things as cooks who can write, and equally writers who can cook. And it's a great pleasure for me to introduce this evening a book that I happen to think is cut from very similar cloth to his. It's an absolute delight to read. And what's particularly amusing is that the lady who's written it, Gabrielle Hamilton, is in charge of a restaurant of her own, just as Anthony Bourdain is himself. Her restaurant, however, is called Prune, interesting name, based in New York as well. And this particular book, which I have before me, is called Blood, Bones, and Butter. And it is an extremely appropriate title for her autobiography. She served in this absolutely relentless profession for well over 20 years. Her restaurant is a proven success, and she writes like a dream. In fact, Anthony Bourdain himself has said on the jacket, inevitably, "Magnificent, simply the best memoir by a chef ever, ever," in italics. I wouldn't go so far as to say that. But I would go so far as to read a passage from this, which I think will give you a flavor of what we're talking about. This is chapter 12, and it starts like this. I met my husband when he started coming to Prune to eat. He was on his way to a popular, crappy Italian spot around the corner where, even though it was a nothing place with cheap German Parmesan standing in for the real thing, and commercial balsamic vinegar in industrial-sized plastic jugs, you had to wait an hour on the sidewalk for a table, naturally. Michel does everything, no matter what, in Italian. He picked our pediatrician because she's Italian. He buys only Italian wine. He roots for Italian soccer teams, reads Italian newspapers, and though he has been in this country for more than 20 years, he's determinedly maintained an Italian accent so thick and a syntax so poor that his English is very often incomprehensible. I apologize for the noises off. That is our office mascot, Oscar, who is announcing himself. Oscar, behave. This is not a provincialism by any stretch, but rather a point of view. Absolutely, couldn't agree more. But he decided to forego the hour-long wait on the sidewalk at the Italian joint and come to check us out. We'd been open for less than a year. He looked in and saw all women in the kitchen, and mostly women on the floor, and, like an Italian, slowed down a minute and took a closer look in through the doors. And then he came in, and then he met and made friends with the hostess and the hostess's girlfriend, and then he made friends with my sous chef and her girlfriend, and then he fell for one of our waitresses and then another of our waitresses, and by then he sort of got the drift of things, until he washed up on the shores of the kitchen and landed his sights on me. This is a delightful book. It's rough and ready and as it is. And as someone who's owned a restaurant himself, and I have had that dubious honor, it's a classic of its type. Warmly recommended, and on that very cheerful gastronomic note.